Hi, welcome to the video. Glad you're here. And we are going to get into something very, very, very important. So listen carefully, calmly, and we will work through this issue. We are going to talk about perception. This is so totally key. The insights that I've had recently really have been stunning, and I've had to, you know, adjust to it. And I'm still adjusting. The most recent one laid bare what perception is all about. And the stunning fact of it is, the instant we identify with sensory perception, okay, we instantly fall into a sleep-like, dream-like, coma-like condition. And this condition deepens and deepens and deepens and deepens and deepens. And it is insidious, actually. Perception is extremely insidious. And it's not something that we're hardly aware of it. We're hardly aware of what's going on. We just know there's something isn't right. And we've forgotten what it is. It is literally sensory perception, our identification with sensory perception brings about an extremely delusional condition where we do not see identity actually. The fact is there's only one identity. There's one shared identity. Perception, sensory perception, gives you the impression of having lost that one identity and feeling that the one identity is here but not over there, or less over there than here. And so it ends up bringing you into this belief system of levels, okay? All sorts of different levels, different gradations, different hierarchies, higher and lower. It's called duality. Perception brings about duality. The belief system we call duality arises from our perception. So when we identify with the physical body and its sensing, its perception, we are in extreme blindness and extreme darkness right at that point, and it just goes into a black hole, really. What we need to do is exchange this physical perception, physical sensory perception, for the Holy Spirit's spiritual perception. And this is the way we must do this. This is something we have to do. We cannot simply produce beautiful stuff, eye candy, for our physical perception and think that that's going to work. It doesn't work. What do I mean by work? I mean it does not awaken us from this dream. It does not free us from this sense of having lost our identity. It doesn't reconcile us back to reality. It doesn't wake us up from the dream at all. It doesn't solve the continuity problem in the slightest bit. So it doesn't work. It doesn't work. So really our problem is a lot worse than we realize. It is way more insidious than we realize. Through perception, a belief system arises that, and a relativism within that belief system is what we call the personality. A personality develops. A personality develops from that. We are not that personality at all. This is entirely the reactions and relativism of perception and saying, well, my perception is here, and over there is not my perception, and over there is farther away, and this is closer to me, and this is brighter, and this is less bright, and this is bigger, and this is smaller. And you get all this relativistic judgment, it's called judgment. Whereas the fact is, there's only one shared identity by all, and the appearances don't have anything to do with this one shared identity. They don't change it or influence it in any way whatsoever. But from our perception, we cannot help but get this insidious sense of judgment going on, that it's like subconscious almost. It's very tough to be conscious of it, but it is taking place constantly. Perception is born of projection. Projection is when we, as spirits, say, I didn't have that idea. That idea came to me, was imposed upon me from out there. So when we say that, then there's a here and a there to our thoughts. And so we think that we're aware of something out there that is trying to attack us here. There and here being different, there being dangerous, here being our identity and safety. And this is perception. Perception is, I am here and the world is out there. Okay, and I'm trying to survive in this world. Projection makes perception. It's born of, perception is born of projection. In reality, there is no perception. There's what's called knowing. Direct, total knowing. We know the oneness. There isn't anything else. So it's completely pure, complete knowing, awareness, without a second, without any possibility of being otherwise. That's not perception. There is no outside here and there in the oneness. There is no here and there. It's not that my perception starts here and goes out there. No, it's direct knowing. Now, our problem is that we are so used to perception, which is projection. We're so used to projection and then perception and belief and personality that we're afraid to set it down. We're afraid to say, this is not what I really want. Set it down and go back to direct knowing of oneness. We're afraid of the abrupt transition. Okay, so that's called the continuity issue, continuity problem. Extremely abrupt transition into a completely different experiencing. We dread that. We dread it. So we say, God, can you help us, please? We have this problem, and God has answered and knows we have a problem. And says, I create the Holy Spirit to specifically deal with this continuity problem that we have with perception, projection, perception, belief, personality. And so what God has made available is a perception of shared identity with all things and non-things, both the manifest and the unmanifest, but a shared identity. I don't know, what is this, UPS or something? Possible. A shared identity. One shared identity. This is called the vision of oneness. And this reminds us of the direct knowing of oneness, without any possibility of it being otherwise. It's beyond a sharedness, okay? It's even beyond that. But again, that's not our goal. Our goal is this vision of shared oneness, that we all share the same one identity. And that identity is not a person, a place, a thing, a location. Anything like that. It's a totally smoothed out, totally peaceful sense of blessing and sacredness is a right way to put it. we identify with the body, mind, perception, this personality complex begins to grow. And there's really no such thing as a quote-unquote good personality. Personality is inherently judgmental. It is inherently deluded. It is inherently without a true sense of identity. And it is desperately, relativistically seeking to find some identity. And it's full of tricks and full of contradictions, and there's no such thing as a good personality. So forget about your personality. Don't worry about trying to get some good personality. It's a waste of time. Instead, work towards getting the vision of oneness, which the Holy Spirit shares with us. It shares its perception with us. It says, here, see everything through my eyes. Or through my eye, through my perception. View it this way. It's like putting on a pair of glasses or something, and now you're viewing everything in a different way. What happens when we are perceiving, identifying with body's perception, sensory perception, we become deluded, and we're not really aware of it. We're not really aware of it. In my case, I was aware of it, but still couldn't figure out a way to get out of it. I recall falling into this, you know, identification, trying not to, and identifying with it, and then this personality, you know, grew, and I said, wow, I don't like this, this is terrible, but it grows automatically. Sensory perception automatically produces this personality complex, this belief system, automatically. Even if you are aware that you fell into identification, it still happens. Happens to everyone, happens to all of us, unless you don't identify at all. Now, we have the testimony of one of the great spiritual helpers that the world has had. There's been quite a few who did not identify with perception, the body's perception, the body-mind. Complex, the belief system did not. They viewed all as one. All as one. There have been. We call them the saints, the great sages, whatever, the great saviors. We have direct testimony of Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, who said that she never ever identified, not even for an instant, with the body mind consciousness. Never. An entire life, including from before birth, and she said before birth, during this life, and after the body passed away, I remain the same. I'm not, never identify with the body mind, with this perception that the body mind is engaged in. So it is possible, and in looking at this example, we find out that we don't have to identify with it. And in not identifying with it, and instead choosing the vision of the Holy Spirit, we get this incredible smoothed out calm and bliss in all circumstances. And everything is equally near and dear to us. Everything feels, whether it's near or distant, is no difference. As far as how we feel about it, we feel everything is our identity, is our one shared identity. It doesn't matter the location at all. It doesn't matter. But this is not pie in the sky talk at all, because there have been teachers here who absolutely exemplify this. in modern times, okay, and I just mentioned one, in modern times, in the midst of world wars, you see two world wars and a whole bunch of other wars. How many wars were there in the 20th century? There's so many, it's hard to even count them. And atrocities, just horrible stuff in the world. Never a ripple in the bliss. The bliss was still completely smooth because everything was equally near and dear. One shared identity without a second. Everything as it is that one shared identity. This is the vision of the Holy Spirit. And we absolutely can have that here. There's no question about it. Part of it is simply that not enough of us has done that, especially recently. So it's kind of like we say, wow, it must be difficult because nobody's doing it. But let's keep in mind that what has happened here in this world, on this planet, which to be factual is full of experts in avoiding right spiritual practice, experts in avoiding the vision of oneness, of shared identity, experts in avoiding the vision of the Holy Spirit. This planet is full of experts in avoiding this, okay? So they're doing their thing, and they're doing it expertly, actually. Very expertly. You got to understand that it is possible to be an expert in avoiding salvation, in avoiding the remedy up to the continuity problem. These are people who are over-identified with their personalities. They don't realize that perception brings about this judgmental, delusional, lack of identity condition where you identify with a personality and try to build up a great grandiose personality, etc. So they're experts in grandiosity. And so they have brought in really very distracting situations to the planet. And so it has made it very, very difficult. At this time, very difficult, but not impossible. It's still actually pretty easy. Is it easy? It's just that we're so distracted, we don't even try. We don't even try. We say, well, there's a nice movie on tonight. I'll try tomorrow. And if you actually are trying, like we are here, you know, in the back of your mind, you're thinking, my God, there's like hundreds of great movies on tonight, and games and frivolous fun stuff where people are yucking it up, and there's like millions of songs. I can dial up any of those songs instantly on my computer or smartphone, whatever. I could be listening to songs all night. I create an incredible playlist. I could do that. I have all this graphic capability of producing videos and graphics. I could do all that. I can be texting people and sending images back and forth. You're thinking of all the stuff that you're not doing, you could be doing and you're not doing. And this causes this gnawing sense of discontent within us. And then we're so agitated by this, we don't even practice at all. This has been going on in this world for quite some time, actually. It hits men hard. Men have got hit real hard, real hard. Both men and women have been hit super hard, super hard, super hard. You know, you go into like a Nordstrom's or something and look at all the shoes, the women's shoes, for instance. You know, it's just like the amount of shoes that women have available to them is just mind-boggling. Mind-boggling. And, you know, it's just like you say, oh my gosh, I mean, I should be, you know, at least getting some of these shoes. And look at these outfits, the amount of clothes. Look at these outfits, and look at these people wearing these new outfits and shoes and stuff. And it's like, wow, I should be doing that. Why am I sitting at home in a drab outfit, listening to somebody talk about? The guys got hit by pornography, for one thing, And the guys are thinking, my gosh, on the internet there's like millions and millions and millions of these of these beautiful women or not so beautiful women, but it completely exposed, you know, and I don't have to spend a fortune to marry them or all this stuff. And they're thinking, says, oh my gosh, you know, there's so many women from all over the world. I could just be viewing them, you know, and just like, wow. And here I am listening to this talk about perception, personality, delusion, projection, perception, vision of oneness, and blah, 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 blah. So the guys have got hit very, very hard as far as distracting their mind, because they think, my gosh, the world is just this very sort of a sexy, sleazy, hedonistic kind of place where you know, the allure is everywhere. And so their minds are like just, you know, agitated by that. It goes all different directions in this world, all different directions about I can entertain myself. I can be entertained to an incredible extent somehow. You know, it's sort of entertainment. I can feed my personality in many different ways, okay? In many different ways, I can feed my personality. Look at all the food that's available, all the fancy food and different stuff. The clothing, everything, you know, the companionship, just the choices are off the charts. You can sit down and get anything you want. Just go on, just, you know, online, you can track it down. You can have it ordered, you know, sent by UPS to your door. If you can afford it. So people are wondering, how can I get more money? How can I just need a little more money. And they say, God, if you just gave me a little more money, I'd be happy. Believe me, I'd be able to feed my personality somehow. Somehow, I'd be able to indulge that. Now, what is the Holy Spirit take on all this? I'll tell you about my situation. It's very interesting, actually. Basically, I don't have any money at all. I'm like incredibly poor. And occasionally, I can spend a little money on like $20 maybe on something. But then it hurts real bad. And I really can't do anything, almost nothing. So what do? I can sit and talk in front of a camera. It doesn't cost me a penny. But as far as doing something else, I can't afford it. Or if I do buy anything, it feels like an extremely stressful situation. I feel I'm really going to pay a severe price for buying the slightest thing. Like, I'd like to go out, for instance, play golf. Can't really afford it, so I don't. But, you know, maybe I can get out like one time, but then I'm thinking, my gosh, I just really can't afford that. And it sort of ruins the feeling of it. That actually helps. To be poor like that actually helps, because I pretty much can't indulge in any of those distractions. I really cannot. I mean, I guess I could watch television, but television is so obviously totally toxic that, you know, there's some things that are just out of the question. Occasionally I'll watch like a baseball game or some golf or something occasionally, but that's it. So what do I do? Pretty much nothing except right spiritual practice and taping. And, you know, not a whole heck of a lot else goes on, actually. Now, I do work, and it takes me around. I'm driving constantly all over the place, so I get to move around a lot, which is helpful. And I tape while I'm driving on an MP3 recorder, and that's helpful. But as far as the world being my oyster, no. I mean, as far as, like, taking a vacation, for instance, you know, forget it. So what does it matter? All these places in the world, to me, all the same, doesn't matter. Won't be going there. All the clothes, all these things, whatever, can't be involved in that. So the Holy Spirit somehow finds a way to center us on right spiritual practice. even if it means taking away all our money and not giving us. I keep saying, come on, Holy Spirit, I need some money. No, no, it doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. And it's interesting that you got to be careful with charity, because somebody who seems to be down and out, or you know, it may be the Holy Spirit's blocking their lives on purpose. So trying to turn them just to right spiritual practice, where they may be somebody who's easily distracted, and as soon as they get some money, you know, they're back, right back in the distraction, right back in it. So if we'd like give them a bunch of money, here you go, they're right back in their distraction. Just like I gave money to a homeless person over time and food, gave so much to them, and one time I watched them and they made a beeline for the liquor store and drank themselves into a stupor, you know, just, that's not the best example, but it does point out the principle of the issue. Being blocked is actually a very good thing. In fact, my main prayer to the Holy Spirit is, Holy Spirit, block me from everything that is preventing me, distracting me from accepting the vision of oneness. That's a great prayer, actually. If you can do that, just say, Holy Spirit, please block everything that is distracting me from accepting the vision of oneness. Just block it, and block it right now. Block it right now. And conversely, if there's something that would help, bring that into the picture right now too. Bring that in the picture right now too. But definitely block everything that's not helpful. And so you may find yourself very blocked, which isn't a bad thing. If I hadn't been blocked in my life, no way would I have discovered what I've discovered. No way. No way possible. Because the personality would have been in charge. And the personality is completely blind. It can't see. It's totally unrealized and unaware of what it is, actually. And it's simply a relativistic belief system complex of reactions that build up from perception, sensory perception. That's what it is. It's not an I. It's not an identity. It's not an identity. The personality is not an identity at all. And this is what some have realized. Somehow some people realize this. Others go about it a different way. And it just, and this realization will just kind of come as a result of going about it a different way. So trying to use the personality to get enlightened doesn't work. It doesn't work. So what happens is you get blocked from feeding the personality. You get blocked that way, and you just can't get the personality rolling at all. You seem to be like, my life is wasted. I'll never amount to anything. My personality, nobody likes it. That's another thing. That's another funny thing. The Holy Spirit blocks it. It somehow, you know, nobody really likes me as far as personality goes. They don't. They absolutely do not. Don't like that. Somehow my personality seems blah to people or whatever. The Holy Spirit does something. When people look at me, it's just, no interest in that person whatsoever. No interest in that person whatsoever. And I always think, like, wow, am I really that terrible? Come on, what is that? It's some kind of blocking situation that's happening, where I cannot make friends, I cannot get into groups, I cannot do anything that's personality based. It doesn't get off the ground at all. But if you recognize this and say, you know what, that's a great opportunity. That's a great opportunity. So it's fine. It's not a problem. Personality cannot lead us to the vision of oneness. It cannot. It's not a identity. It's not an intelligence. It's a complex that's been built up through the relativism of sensory perception. And at some point, we realize this, which is a huge milestone. I haven't had the complete aha moment yet, but it's coming. That there never was a personal self. There is no personal self. There is no personality self. in terms of identity. It's just the dualistic relativism of sensory perception, which sees everything as different, based on location, based on qualities and location, based on relevance to the sensory perception. It's judgmental. It's inherently judgmental. It's inherently based on a projection. The original projection being spirit projecting spirit's idea of wanting to displace God onto God, and said God is trying to displace spirit. That was the original projection. And from that, literally has brought about our situation here, where we think we're this body, and the body's, we think through this personality, which is again something that grows from perception. When we're born and the brain and sensory perception get going, this personality automatically forms. And when we die, this personality complex actually is being made of reactions and thoughts and stuff. It's subtle. It's actually subtle. It actually survives death. Actually survives the death of the body. And it gradually too decays and decays. But when we're reborn, we have a tendency that this personality complex is still seeking. It's a seeking. It's the momentum of seeking. Seeking identity. Seeking really to forget identity. And then there's a whole bunch of information of why, how we come back to this world and what situation we put ourselves in. But that's not important, actually. It's not important. It doesn't matter at all, because it's not the vision of oneness. It doesn't solve anything. Just being real smart about all this stuff doesn't solve anything. But you will find that you have a very similar personality to the previous life. The same kind of seeking traits, you know, the same kind of judgmental traits of what you think is good and what you think is bad, and where you think how you can feed the personality. How do you feed the personality? How do you go about feeding that personality? Some will come in and they'll just make tons of money, you know. That's the trait that they have developed, of just becoming super, super rich, you know, that kind of thing. Others, they'll come in and they'll just feel like just being a wanderer is the way to do it. Others, they want to just live at the beach. They want to have a house overlooking the ocean and stroll on the beach and just be near to the ocean. They have to have others, forest. They got to be in the forest. Others, it's the desert. Got to be in the desert. And the different types of recreation, different types of lifestyles, all this stuff, personality, feeding itself. But what we really want is to have that block. That's what happened to me. All the ways I had of trying to feed the personality feeding itself, they were severely blocked. And I was like, wow, I can't seem to make myself happy. No matter what I do, things go wrong, and I have to get blocked. It's like something wrong with me, you know. Sort of, if you feel like maybe God doesn't love you, is what you feel. It's just the opposite, actually. It's actually getting blocked is an expression of God's love, because it's only that, only by having the personality blocked in many different ways, do we actually begin to spend the time to do the right kinds of considerations and right spiritual practice, which then leads us to accepting the vision of oneness. It leads us in that direction. So, the world is a very, 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 very insidious place. It's not what it pretends to be, or we pretend it to be at all. And it's easy to go down, 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 down. But it's also easy to get free of this. But distractions get in the way. They get in the way. Now, I'm aware that there's a certain point in development where spirit is still not really identified with physical consciousness, sensory perception so much. And there's a point when it starts getting interested in if you ask spirit, why are you doing this? They'll say, it's fun. I just want to see what it's like. It's going to be fun. It's kind of like you're walking in public and you decide just to close your eyes and let's just see what happens. Let's just close your eyes as you're walking around and see what happens to you. It's kind of really like that. Let's just close our eyes and find out what happens. Well, that doesn't work out very well. In fact, we may find ourselves in terrible situations. What we're trying to do is we're trying to open our eyes. We're trying to wake up. So, with that in mind, with what's being said here in mind, there are definitely easy practices to do. Easy. But there's a way to view things. We're going to change the way we view the situation. It's a practicing changing, conceptually changing the way we view situations, getting comfortable with that. And we say, the appearance of that plant spaciousness is perfectly centered in the one shared identity. Okay, this is the way we would talk. But there's a way of talking. When you're waking up, there's a way of talking. Not many people talk this way. But there's a way of talking. Instead of that thing, look at that plant. That appearance of plant spaciousness. An appearance of plant spaciousness is one way to put it. You're looking at an appearance of this appearance of table spaciousness. Or you can say this appearance in spaciousness as table, as tableness. This tableness appearance in spaciousness. There are various ways you can kind of, but you're trying to conceptually change your basic orientation. Change your basic perceptual orientation. You're not looking at things. You're looking at appearances and spaciousness. That appearance in spaciousness we call mountain is the one shared identity, is centered in the one shared identity. So it's not always easy to come up with. All day long I've been trying to come up with the right practice, and so I work on it very, very hard to get this. So you could say this car spaciousness, this car appearance in spaciousness, that mountain appearance in spaciousness, that sign appearance in spaciousness, this road appearance in spaciousness, all are the one shared identity. The appearance and spaciousness of this mountain, of that mountain, the appearance and spaciousness of this plant, the appearance and spaciousness as this road, the appearance and spaciousness of this tree, all these appearances are the one shared identity. See, it's not quite right yet. It's not quite right. But this is the kind of struggle that you need to go through. You need to work on your own way of expression and perceiving and say, I'm going to change the way I perceive the world. And I need to consciously make that effort, my own effort. So you can see I'm making a conscious effort here to try and get the right smoothness to it. This appearance of spaciousness as plant is the one shared identity, is optimally centered in the one shared identity. This appearance of spaciousness, this spaciousness appearing as this plant, or pure spaciousness appearing as this plant, spaciousness appearing as this plant is optimally centered in the one shared identity. Optimally centered as the one shared identity. Is the one shared identity. Spaciousness appearing as that mountain. Spaciousness appearing as this car. Spaciousness appearing as this room. Spaciousness appearing as this table. Spaciousness appearing as that window. Spaciousness appearing as this space, spaciousness appearing as these surroundings. All of this spaciousness is the one shared identity. All the spaciousness is perfectly centered in the one shared identity. All of the spaciousness is totally the one shared identity. Now it may not click. It's not clicking for me right now. That's okay. It's making the efforts, you really begin to turn things around. Pure spaciousness appearing as crystallized spaciousness, crystallized plantness. Pure spaciousness appearing as plantness. This plant spaciousness is pure spaciousness. This room spaciousness is pure spaciousness. This surrounding is pure spaciousness. These surroundings is pure spaciousness. That mountain is pure spaciousness. This road here and that road over there share the one identity. That mountain over there and that hill over there and right here, this seat here are the one shared identity. So what I was doing was I'm saying something close and then something far away. Locations say that it's all the same, one shared identity, share one identity, that of spaciousness. So it's very important to realize that in doing right spiritual practice, it's not like you're reading out of a book and then repeating the lines. I can repeat the line, okay, I did that, okay, I repeated this line. No, you've got to struggle with it organically. It's a struggle. Sometimes you have incredible breakthroughs, other times You know, you're kind of like, you know, reaching for something. I can't quite dial it in. I can't quite dial it in. So this is an example. I've been able to dial it in today. It's frustrating. And occasionally I get it dialed and then I forget. But this is probably more instructive than just, you know, easily saying something. Because each one of us have to organically struggle with coming up with our own words. And you can feel it when you get it right, that it's just right for right now. You feel this traction and you feel like, oh my gosh, somehow there's this smoothing out has happened. And suddenly it's like a door is open in some way. And a realization will come and you'll get a glimpse and you'll feel like, wow, that wasn't so difficult. This spaciousness here and that spaciousness there are the one shared identity. This spaciousness here, that spaciousness there is the one pure spaciousness, the one pure identity. Is the one identity. Still coming up short. So this is spiritual practice. Now, instead of going in there and, you know, watching television, I'm going to try and see if I can't get this right. It's like practicing a musical instrument. Somehow you can't quite get the rhythm right. And you may practice for 4 or 5, 6 hours. I used to practice just incredible amounts of time. And say, I'm not going to quit until I get this just right. Even going late at night, you know, no, I just got to get this thing right. The vision of oneness is the vision of one shared identity. Everything sharing one identity. This plant is that shared identity. This table is so if it doesn't click, you stay calm, you stay poised, you stay patient. Shared identity is totally now. The one shared identity is totally now. The one shared identity is without a second. The one shared identity is without a second. This appearance of table spaciousness as it is the peace of the one shared identity. This plant spaciousness as it is the perfect peace of the one shared identity. That mountain over there, this pebble here, as it is the one, that mountain over there as it is, this is the pebble here as it is the perfect piece of the one shared identity. The world as it is, this mountain as it is, this rock as it is, this dirt as it is the one shared identity, is the perfect piece of the one, is released as it is released, is totally released now as the one shared identity. Okay, still getting a little better. This universe as it is, this this world spaciousness as it is, this universe spaciousness as it is, this world spaciousness as it is, that mountain spaciousness as it is, this dirt spaciousness as it is the perfect peace, is totally, is the person perfect, is the perfect peace, is totally the perfect peace now of the one shared identity. This world spaciousness, this world appearance spaciousness, this plant appearance spaciousness as it is the totally smoothed out bliss of the one shared identity. This nighttime spaciousness appearance, this, that cosmic space spaciousness appearance, this white spaciousness appearance as it is, is the totally smoothed out piece of the one shared identity. This world as it is, this world, this this spaciousness as world, that's what I'm having a problem with. Okay, spaciousness, pure spaciousness as world appearance. As it is the totally smoothed out piece of the one shared identity. Those people over there, that person there, this person here, those people over there. Spaciousness as those people, that person appearance. As it is, spaciousness as those people appearance. As it is, those bodies appearance. Spaciousness as the world population appearance as it is the totally smoothed out, peaceful bliss of the one shared identity. And that one shared identity is now. That one shared identity is now. Spaciousness as car appearance, as it is the totally smoothed out peace and bliss of the one shared identity of everything right now. Spaciousness as everything, as spaciousness appearing as everything, as it is the totally smoothed out piece of the one shared identity. Spaciousness appearing as all tree spaciousness appearance. Spaciousness appearing as all trees is the totally smoothed out, perfectly same, peaceful, stillness of the one shared identity, one without a second, that is right now, that is now. Spaciousness appearing as dirt. Spaciousness. The dirt appearance of spaciousness. The dirt appearance of spaciousness. As it is. The dirt appearance of spaciousness as it is this perfectly, totally smoothed out bliss of the one shared identity. Plant appearing spaciousness is the totally smoothed out bliss of the one shared identity. See, we're starting to turn things around here. It's been an all day effort. It's a tough one, isn't it? Turning it around is just very tough. You could say plant-like spaciousness. Plant-like spaciousness as it is. Is the one shared identity. Air appearance spaciousness. So see, this is like a reality show. It shows us the struggle that goes on. It's not like it's just easy for me like that. No way. You see someone at some point, a musician playing something so easily, well, you know that they've been practicing like crazy to get it that easy. Planet appearing spaciousness, dirt appearing spaciousness, space appearing spaciousness, air appearing spaciousness, rock appearing spaciousness, rock appearing spaciousness, brick appearing spaciousness, concrete appearing spaciousness. Ocean appearing spaciousness. All spaciousness, all appearances of spaciousness, it is the one shared identity. Body appearing spaciousness. This rock appearing spaciousness is the one shared identity. the spaciousness that includes this rock, the spaciousness that includes this mountain, the spaciousness, oh, then that can seem like it's surrounding the things. We want to get the feeling of not something that's surrounding things, but something that is the things. This spaciousness occupying bottle, this spaciousness occupying plant, this spaciousness occupying table, all are the one shared identity. See, the mind is trying to not get it. The personality is fighting against it. And this is the struggle, because the personality says, well, if you look at it that way, I don't get it. If you look at it that way, I don't get it. We don't want to look at something and say, this is a flower. We want to look and say, this is the one shared identity. This is the one shared identity is revealed in this flower. The one shared identity is revealed in that mountain. The one shared identity is totally revealed in this flower. The one shared identity is totally revealed in that plant. The one shared identity is totally revealed in this space. The one shared identity totally revealed by this wall is, let's see. The one shared identity totally revealed by this wall is the same one shared identity totally revealed by this plant, is the same one shared identity totally revealed by this concrete, is the same one shared identity totally revealed by this tree, is the same one shared identity totally revealed by this air. The one shared identity stands revealed as this mountain, stands revealed as this plant, stands revealed as this table, stands revealed as these stones. The one shared identity stands revealed to me as this air, as this sky. Stands revealed, the one shared identity stands revealed to me as this sky, as this plant, as this pavement, as this dirt is, so am I, as this dirt is, so is this plant is, so is that mountain is, so is the world is, so is the universe. As everything is, so is everything is. So is everything. As everything is, so is everything. The one shared identity, the totally one, without a second, shared identity stands revealed as this. As that mountain, as that hill, as that valley, that valley stands revealed as the one shared identity. The one shared identity stands revealed as that valley. So what we're kind of doing is we're getting a conceptual framework. So when the vision of oneness comes to us, we'll feel like, well, I have a sort of a familiar conceptual framework, because that's what we're so used to. So you don't feel like you're just completely have no way to even relate to others, to the world, etc. We can say yes, the one shared identity is equally revealed to me, equally as that valley over there, as this river over there, as this little hill here, as this seat here, this seat. The one shared identity stands revealed as this seat. The seat reveals the one shared identity to everything. Everything reveals the one shared identity to this seat. This table reveals the one shared identity to that mountain. That mountain reveals the one shared identity to that ocean. That ocean reveals the one shared identity to this table. And this table reveals the one shared identity to everything. This plant totally reveals the one shared identity to everything. Everything totally reveals the one shared identity to this plant. So I wonder how many of you are getting this teaching in your schooling. You go into a classroom and this is what you hear. You walk in and, okay, welcome to our class today. And you ready? Okay, now here we go. This desk, as it is, totally reveals the one shared identity to that blackboard. And that blackboard totally reveals the one shared identity to those lights. And those lights totally reveal the one shared identity to your body. And your body totally reveals the one shared identity to this desk. And this desk totally reveals the one shared identity to this building. And this building totally reveals the one shared identity to this, to this playground. And this playground totally reveals the one shared identity to that street. And that street totally reveals the one shared identity to this town. And this town totally reveals the one shared identity with this state. And this state totally totally reveals that one shared identity with this nation. And this nation totally reveals the one shared identity to the planet. And this planet totally reveals the one shared identity to that blackboard. And that blackboard totally reveals the one shared identity with this desk. How difficult is that? How come we didn't get that education growing up? Everything totally reveals the one shared identity to this space right here. And this space right here totally reveals the one shared identity with everything everywhere, with everything everywhere, right now. This desk totally blesses that blackboard, and that blackboard totally blesses the building, and this building totally blesses the city, and this city totally blesses the country, and this country totally blesses the cosmos, And the cosmos totally blesses this world. And this world totally blesses this state. And this state totally blesses this desk. And this desk totally blesses this pencil. And this pencil totally blesses this book. And this book totally blesses the world. And everything is the one shared identity. And everything blesses everything as the one shared identity. Everything is one. And the one shared identity blesses this book. And the one, and this book blesses, totally blesses this classroom. And you're thinking, oh, I forgot the world. I forgot the personality. What am I supposed to do with the personality? I forgot. I'm supposed to what? Listen to some music? I forgot the music. I'm supposed to go gossip with friends. I forgot who my friends are. I forgot to gossip. Right? It's gone. Can't remember what time it is. Not sure. It doesn't matter. Because this time, this moment totally blesses yesterday. And yesterday totally blesses tomorrow. And tomorrow totally blesses this moment. This moment totally blesses yesterday. And yesterday totally blesses last year. And last year totally blesses next year. And next year totally blesses 1,000 years ago. And 1,000 years ago blesses the entire future. And the entire future blesses the entire past. And the entire past blesses right now. And right now blesses all time. And all time blesses right now. See, this is getting traction now. See, if you don't quit, you keep going for it. You develop a new style comes up suddenly. Wow. This is a more powerful way of doing practice. It's more traction to it. Wow. chain of awakening. This chain of awakening. It's a chain of practice. It doesn't stop, does it? You can just keep it going. And before you know it, you've reoriented your yourself. It's like the old orientation is like, I can't really, it's become fuzzy. Who I thought I was, or has become fuzzy. The personality's become fuzzy. It's sort of foggy and kind of evaporating. I can't call to mind my preferences really. Because preferences make the person, right? And right now, I've sort of forgotten my preferences about everything. So the personality has been deflated, but just by doing these exercises. And I'm not trying to remember, I'm not struggling to remember, I'm just aware that there really isn't any preferences arising in my mind right now about anything. At least not overtly or strongly or anything, no. So, that form of practice, which I've never come across before, is very strong, very effective. So we should be engaged in coming up with right spiritual practice. And each one of us can come up with something that works well for us, actually. There's some forms that'll probably work well for everybody. This tree is the one identity, as this mountain is the one identity, as this forest is the one shared identity, as this tree is the one shared identity, as this flower is the one shared identity, as this lake is the one shared identity, as this sky is the one shared identity, as this river is the one shared identity, as that grass is the one shared identity, as this trail is the one shared identity, as this road is the one shared identity, as this car is the one shared identity, as this camera is the one shared identity, as this person is the one shared identity, as that cliff is the one shared identity, as that cloud is the one shared identity, as that bird is the one shared identity, as that telephone pole is the one shared identity, as that weed is the one shared identity, as that pebble is the one shared identity, as that can is the one shared identity, as this food is the one shared identity, as this watch is the one shared identity, as that dog is the one shared identity, as this mountain is the one shared identity, as this air is the one shared identity, as this breath is the one shared identity, as this thought is the one shared identity, as that bug is the one shared identity, you see, as everything is the one shared identity, as everything is the one shared identity, as the unmanifest is the one shared is this shared one identity, as the manifest is the shared one identity, as everything is the one shared identity, as this thing is the one shared identity, as this speck of dust is the one shared identity, as that leaf is the one shared identity, as that stem is the one shared identity, as that shadow is the one shared identity, as that fence post is the one shared identity, as that wall is the one shared identity, as that house is the one shared identity, as that smoke is the one shared identity, as that haze is the one shared identity, as this quietness is the one shared identity, as this spaciousness is the one shared identity, as this vista is the one shared identity, as this star field is the one shared identity, as this galaxy is the one shared identity, as this planet is the one shared identity, as this home is the one shared identity, as this community is the one shared identity, as that country is the one shared identity, as that person is the one shared identity, as that place is the one shared identity, as that bridge is the one shared identity, as that fountain is the one shared identity, as this quiet is the one shared identity, as this activity is the one shared identity, as the totality is the totality, is the one shared identity, is totally now. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. There is only this one shared identity. It is one. This total shared, all as one shared identity. All share in this one identity of equal vision, of non-locational importance. Each is as near and dear as everything else. We are the one shared near and dearest identity. So we're making progress here. There still feels like there's some more progress to be made. the sacredness of this can blesses the sacredness, or shares the sacredness of this rubble, shares the sacredness of this road, shares the sacredness of this traffic, shares the sacredness of this rain, shares the sacredness of this puddle, shares the sacredness of this light, shares the sacredness of this building, shares the sacredness of this sunset, shares the sacredness of this moment, shares the sacredness of that bird, shares the sacredness of those people, shares the sacredness of these palm trees, shares the sacredness of this breath, shares the sacredness of this day, shares the sacredness of these surroundings. These surroundings share the sacredness of those surroundings, and those surroundings share the sacredness of those other surroundings, and those other surroundings share the sacredness of this cosmos, and this cosmos shares the sacredness of this planet, and this planet shares the sacredness of this tree, and this tree shares the sacredness of this forest. And all share the sacredness right now, totally now. And all of this shared sacredness is totally now. And all of this shared sacredness is totally now. Sacredness is totally now. This is totally now. This is totally now. This is totally now. All sacredness is totally now. All shared sacredness is totally now. All blessing is totally now. All shared blessing is totally now. All shared blessing is totally now. All shared identity is totally now. All shared nowness is totally now. All shared oneness is totally now. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. Now blesses now. Now blesses now. The now of tomorrow blesses the now of the past. The now of the past blesses the now of today. And now totally blesses now. So this definitely has put a damper on the personality and all its preferences. Seems very subdued. Now if you get a song in your head, how do you stop that? Say, this song blesses that song, and that song blesses this other song, and this other song blesses another song, and this song blesses, that song blesses this song, and this song blesses that song, and this song is a blessing to that song. This song shares sacredness with this other song, and this other song shares sacredness with this other song, and this other song shares sacredness with this other song, and this other song shares sacredness with the world, And the world shares sacredness with this song. And this song shares sacredness with the ocean. And the ocean shares sacredness with the forest. And the forest shares sacredness with the dirt. And the dirt shares sacredness with this rock. And this rock shares sacredness with this bottle. And this bottle shares sacredness with this galaxy. And this galaxy shares sacredness with this song. So when you're getting stuck and going around, this like one song, start doing this chain practice. Now you can do a walk, you can do a walk through, and as you're walking, you say this, you know, whatever you see, this plant totally shares sacredness with that tree as you're walking. That tree shares total sacredness with that flower. That flower shares total sacredness with that hill. And as you're walking, whatever you're seeing, practice including everything you're seeing, just not everything, but just whatever is, you can include. Just do that sort of chain practice like that. There's no gap there. Very powerful practice. Never done that before. And the personality feels definitely very subdued. Now I'm probably going to go inside and try to reconstitute it, you know. Okay, so what are we working on? What's that song I like? What was I working on? And then we get back to feeding the personality. But the potency of this form of practice is off the charts. You know, say, this desk blesses that blackboard. This desk totally blesses that blackboard. That blackboard totally blesses this school. This school totally blesses the ocean. The ocean totally blesses this locker. This locker totally blesses that airport. That airport totally blesses this plant. This plant totally blesses that country. That country totally blesses this ant. This ant totally blesses that pot. That pot totally blesses this food. This food shares total blessing with that post. That post shares total blessing or sacredness. That post radiates total sacredness to that garden. That garden radiates total sacredness to that sun. That sun radiates total sacredness to this electrical outlet. This electrical outlet radiates total sacredness to this bottle. This bottle radiates total sacredness to that shoe. That shoe radiates total sacredness to that guardrail. That guardrail radiates total sacredness to that root. That root radiates total sacredness to that can. That can radiates total sacredness to that reflector. That reflector radiates total sacredness to that bike. That bike radiates total sacredness to those people. Those people radiate total sacredness to this camera. This camera radiates total sacredness to that flower. That flower radiates total sacredness to that window. That window radiates total sacredness to that cat. That cat radiates total sacredness to the moon, to that moon. That moon radiates total sacredness to this river. This river radiates total sacredness to this song, Moon River. And this song radiates total sacredness to this planet. And this planet radiates total sacredness to that gravesite. And that gravesite radiates total sacredness to that sky. And that sky radiates total sacredness to that hospital. And that hospital radiates total sacredness to that beach. And that beach radiates total sacredness to that restaurant. And that restaurant radiates total sacredness to this sewing machine. And the sewing machine radiates total sacredness to this room. And this room radiates total sacredness to this house. And this house radiates total sacredness to that tree. And that tree radiates total sacredness to that fly. And that fly radiates total sacredness to the universe. And the universe radiates total sacredness to the universe. And now is totally now. And now is totally now. And all sacredness, all radiated sacredness is totally now. All peace is totally now. Peace is totally now. All peace is totally now. All happiness is totally now. All vision is totally now. All now is totally now. See, we're no longer looking at the person from a personality level. You see, we're practicing awareness, expression, awareness, constant focus, at the level of spirit instead of personality, instead of sensory perception. See, sensory perception doesn't see this way. It doesn't see equal vision, sameness, sameness, smoothed out sameness. It doesn't see that way. It doesn't see that way. We can say that, but it doesn't see that way. It doesn't see that way. So we're practicing seeing in a different way, at least getting ready for it, getting accustomed to it. So you can practice right in, close by, stuff close by, and then go farther away, and then from farther away, go back to close by. This fingernail totally blesses that fish in the ocean, to the fish in the, that fish in the ocean totally blesses this plant. This plant totally blesses that boulder. That rock in Australia. Okay, something. That rock in Australia totally blesses this light at this house. This light totally blesses that iceberg in Antarctica. That iceberg totally blesses this butterfly that's flying around. This butterfly totally blesses that cave in the Himalayas. That cave in the Himalayas totally blesses this camera tripod. So get used to near and far, and like and different, you know, different things. Cave in the Himalayas, camera tripod. This camera tripod totally blesses that sky. That sky totally blesses this TV dinner. And this fried chicken totally blesses totally blesses that fog. That mist in Africa, and that mist in Kilimanjaro, for instance, that mist in Kilimanjaro totally blesses this seat right here. And this seat right here totally blesses that concrete wall in Europe. And that concrete wall in Europe totally blesses this shrubbery right here. And this shrubbery totally blesses that whale in the Pacific. And that whale in the Pacific totally blesses this ring right here. And this ring blesses that diamond in South Africa, diamond mine. And that diamond in South Africa totally blesses this lawn. And this lawn totally blesses that coastline in Italy. And that coastline in Italy totally blesses this plate. And this plate totally blesses that tundra in Siberia. And that tundra in Siberia totally blesses this shirt. And this shirt totally blesses that temple in Japan. You see, so you can jump around the world from all the different continents. And it's important not to focus too much on people and bodies and persons so much. We tend, because what happens, the personality wants to talk about other personalities. It thinks it's reinforcing itself that way. So, you know, you can tell the personality when they love to talk about persons and other personalities. So we got to try to avoid that. I really don't like talking about people or personalities at all. I think, forget it. Not important, no value there. So that's why we shy away, for the most part, from talking about people, bodies, that kind of thing. Keep it, you know, don't start getting into that too heavy, then that's a personality will easily start bouncing back. And so say, what are they like? And how am I this different from them or the same with them? Immediately you start getting to this. That's why when you get around people, you tend to get into the personality. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to get out of the personality. So the personality seems to just vanish as we're doing these exercises. I'm not aware of any personality, actually. This table, one identity that is shared as revealed by that tree, which reveals the shared identity as revealed by that forest, which reveals the one shared identity revealed by that ocean, which reveals the one shared identity as revealed by that mountain. That mountain shares the one identity as revealed by this planet. This planet shares the one identity as revealed by this table. This table shares the one identity as revealed by that mountaintop. That mountaintop shares the one revealed identity, shares the one identity as revealed by that dog. That dog shares the one identity as revealed by that house. That house shares the one identity as revealed by that person. That person shares the one identity as revealed by that star. That star shares the one revealed identity as revealed by this breath. This breath shares the one identity as revealed by that river. That river shares the one identity as revealed by this stone. And this stone shares the one identity as revealed by everything. And everything shares the one identity as revealed by that stone. And that stone is now. That stone is totally now. That stone as it is totally now. That stone as it is totally now. This table as it is totally now. So, probably have to stop at some point, just to see, just to, I don't know. I don't know what's going to be there, actually, at this point. Is the personality even going to be there? I guess it will be. The world has a way of, pushing us back into our personality, doesn't it? It's gets you focused on the personality. There's lots of ways this can be used, actually, and probably will be used in many, many ways by many, many people in the future. You can use it for things you're real sensitive about, politically sensitive about, upset about, and just start doing this chain, doing this chain, doing this chain, reveals this blessing. And before you know it, I guarantee you the whole upset will be completely evaporated. Your sensitivities will be evaporated. Your personality will no longer be responding like that. You'll have a different perspective, like, wow. This is way better. It just seems to evaporate the personality and all its sensitivities. This personality is so sensitive because it can't find identity. And it feels that there's someone out there robbing it of identity. And if someone out there just speaks the way they want them to speak, then the personality says, oh, I'll get identity. If they just act the way they want them to act, then I'll get identity then. If they just behave the way, do what you want them to do, you say, okay, I feel like I'm going to get identity now. But if they don't do exactly what you want them to do, you say, I'm losing my identity. They're stealing it. They're depriving me of it. Projection, projection, projection. So, at some point, maybe I'll expand this into more areas that people might get more like, you can't talk about that. So, I don't know. We'll see. It might become overly sensitized. People wouldn't take it the wrong way. But you could even practice it for yourself on anything that you're sensitive to or upset about. This lie, this lie reveals, radiates the bliss of shared one shared identity with this disrespect, which reveals the one shared identity, which radiates the bliss of the one shared identity with this ignorance, which radiates the bliss of this one shared identity with this deceit, and you can kind of go on that way too, different ways, feelings, all whatever. As you just practice this chain, and each one is revealing, the one shared identity. And this chain, this whole chain, there's no end to this chain, there's no end to the chain. I Let me see, what happened to the personality? Wait a minute. I was angry a couple minutes ago. Someone said something I didn't like. I was infuriated. Or I didn't get the attitude I wanted. What happened? But now it's like, what was I thinking? I don't know. It's gone. It's gone. All right. So we seem to be winding down here. Which is fine. All right. Very great. That's good for right now. And we will see what the coming hours bring. All right. Very great. That's it.